All right, I've bought the head indoors, not least because it's cold outside, and I've noticed it's got some rust, particularly round here. There's also some rust down there. Well, I'm going to treat that with some rust treatment, and this is some stuff I got off the eBay or something. And also, I've got to remove the head gasket, and for that, I'm going to use this part of an old Stanley plane, I think. It's the inside of a Stanley plane, which works very well as a scraper, and I'll get on with it, I think. So I gave this stuff a shake. It's been in the garage for ages, and it'll be interesting to see if this actually stands the temperature test. Just paint it on, really. Part of today's procedure is to get rid of the base gasket that's sitting on the base of the thingy here. It's a paper gasket, and it's well and truly stuck on there, I tell you. It's a question of getting through the paper gasket, getting to the bottom of the cylinder head, the cylinder barrel there, and it's got layers of paper. Just be able to get under it and lift the whole thing off. Not having it. There you go, that was a bit. Went into the reed block. I'm sure I'll clean it out then. Big pieces. Probably didn't even need to do this, could have just put it straight on with that whole gasket on there. And I've never really had one leak, actually, but I know that it wouldn't be a lot of fun if it did. It would be one of those little niggles, really. It's the remains of the old gasket. Nearly all gone. Just mixes up with the old oil and kind of turns into a hard old sort of cardboard, not cardboard, hard old substance anyway. How deep is this gasket? Goodness. All right, got to the end of it. It's just a little, that's it. So that's my old gasket all gone. Now, made quite a mess. Bits of paper, I don't know what it is actually, it's paper mixed with oil, gone hard. Blade, all this sort of grey stuff. Anyway, I'll give this a good go with the air hose. DT50mx. This is known as the barrel leading, and this is the exhaust port. This arrow on the piston always points at the exhaust port, so it will be going in like this. I'm going to use a bit of oil. Today's oil is 10W30. Or is it fork oil? Hang on, yeah, that's interesting. It's a bit on the colourful side. Right, so you have to make sure that your piston rings are lined up with your pegs. Rotate the piston, find the arrow. There's the arrow. So you know it has to go in like this direction. Well, if you're going to do it my way, what you have to do is you need if you're going to do it my way, you need to be able to see the hole for the for the gudgeon pin. Okay, so it's too far in at the moment. You have to lead, but I wanted to test whether this is actually, I mean, it's so exceptionally tight. I've never known anything like it. Boy, that's tight. I'm going to take it out and check it. Or maybe not. I don't know. I mean, it's... You do need to have that kind of leeway on it. And it needs to be... there. Oh. Certainly in there now. And it's not going to break, he says, playing his last words. Right, anyway, if you're going to do it my way, you need to make sure you can see the hole for the gudgeon pin. So, this way you're just putting the piston in the lead in before it's on the con rod, or whatever it's called, the connecting rod to the crankshaft. Anyway, so you can see the thingy. Just got to put these studs in properly with a bit of what's the word? Well, when I installed this pull choke carburetor, I didn't put these studs in particularly well. I didn't have any threadlock at the time. Some A43 threadlock. seems to be stuck in there quite well, but I don't think it is. So I'm gonna see how easy it comes out. If it doesn't come out, I won't lock it. At least it shouldn't vibrate under the weight of the vibrations from the engine motor. So today's gasket kit is a cylinder head, base gasket, and exhaust gasket, a small end bearing, and I've put the piston in the barrel in the correct rotation. The gudgeon pin's going to go in the hole, and I've got to go and put the base gasket on first, and I can put the small end bearing in the conrod as well, so I'll go and get on with it. It's time to take out the rag that was stopping stuff falling in there. Goodness me, it's stuck to the bloody packet. I always think if you can see the print, it goes that way up. Ain't gonna let me get started. Of the studs. Remember to put your conrod through the base gasket. Just putting the old tissue paper back in there, because just in case the small end bearing decides to take a walk out of the conrod here. Take the packet there. W30 today. Whoa, it's falling through, look at that. What bugger. Oops, another age-related dent. At this point I'm going to take the tissue out and hope that the small end bearing don't drop out while I'm busy doing this little thing. I pulled the gasket up while I was removing the tissue there. Oh, hang on, this thing seems to be a little bit caught on something. Here we go. I just find it easier to put the gudgeon pin in and the piston thread and the piston rings up the use me anyway. Probably won't now I'm here. So I've pushed the gudgeon pin in and it's gone, whoa, hang on, yeah, it's gone just far enough in so that the groove for the gudgeon pin retaining circlip is quite visible in there, and that's all we've got to fit now. Just needs the gudgeon pin retaining circlip and that's the piston installation complete. seemed to go in with a bit of a click. Gasket to go on there. Now with these gaskets I always put that with the ridge facing down. Today I'm going to put it with the ridge facing up because I feel lucky, you know. I don't actually think it makes a lot of difference. And now that I've got it on record, which way up I put it, getting in the way again. Today's torque is 14.7 newton meters. Thank you. haven't connected the oil. Naughty boy. What's scary though is that there's no oil coming out of that. I have to bleed it. Bleeding thing. I've got to say, it don't sound any better, which is amazing.